To me, there is no right or wrong in lesson planning. It depends on the situation and whether you can use your professional judgment as a teacher to successfully help the students achieve the learning objectives based on their needs. Usually, I would advise teachers not to plan too much, but not to plan too little either. If you plan too much, the students may be overwhelmed and not to be able to digest all the teaching materials and contents. In fact, a lesson in Hong Kong typically lasts for 40 to 45 minutes. So realistically, you cannot do too much. Some teachers plan in a very detailed way. They think about how they should ask certain questions and how their students will respond. Although it is good to detect what's going on, you should not overdo it. Otherwise, you would disrupt the flow of the lesson. But of course, on the other hand, you should not plan too little as well. Particularly regarding the teaching content, because you need to be well prepared and flexible. For example, if your students learn at a really fast pace, you may teach more. It is therefore important for teachers to have a larger plan for the teaching of a whole topic or unit, not just for individual lessons. At the same time, a teacher must also have sufficient knowledge on the subject matter, the learning abilities of their students, and different teaching methodologies. Another important point teachers should be aware of is the school context. Sometimes their teaching styles may not align with the practices of the school, and the students may become confused, and tensions may arise between other members of the school community too. This would incredibly something teachers must be careful of. So this is why when we conduct teaching practice supervisions, we will consider the teacher's combined content knowledge, ability to teach the subject matter, implementation of teaching and learning activities, application of assessment to enhance teaching and learning, caring and catering for their student teachers, and also the teaching evaluation and last but not the least, we also consider their students' development, the teachers' adaptabilities to the school, their professional relationships in the school, and how well they co-work with the other teachers. All of these items will be considered and well implemented by professional teachers.